Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2200, filter by quarter in a pivot table with daily dates. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a great trick from Lindsey in Nashville. I was in Nashville doing a seminar for the Lincoln Trail Council of the IMA. It's seminar season, so I'm bringing all these great tricks from the road back to you. Lindsey has daily dates in her pivot table data, and she wants to be able to filter by quarter. So here's how we do that. Insert, pivot table, OK. All right, now, first step, some pre-work. Before you build the pivot table, take that date field to the rows area. All right, see, and I'm getting daily dates. If you're getting a grouped date, immediately press control+Z. I don't like when they automatically group because they have weird rules. If it spans an entire year, they group one way. But if it doesn't, see, my data starts on January 2nd, not January 1st, because it was a holiday. And so they give me a different grouping, right? Sorry, Excel, we're going to turn this off. File, Options, Data, that's a new category in Office 365. And right here, Disable Automatic Grouping of the Date Time Columns in a Pivot Table. All right, if you don't have that checkbox, then you're just going to have to press control+Z if you're in the perpetual version of Excel 2016. So we choose our first date field, go to Group Field, choose just quarters. Now, this data only spans 1 year, so quarters is right. Click OK, we get our quarters there, and now here's the cool thing, take that up to the filters area. All right, now we're going to build our pivot table, whatever pivot table you need to do. I'm going to build a report of revenue by sector. I'll take revenue twice, click on this heading and change the values to a percentage of the column total, so percentage of total. All right, maybe add a little bit of number formatting here, right click, number format, choose currency with zero decimal places, click OK. All right, so there's our pivot table. But now we can filter, open the drop down. Here's the answers for Q1. And I suppose once you have this, it would really be better to insert a slicer by the date field. That date field now contains quarters, and I can very quickly update the report using one of the slicers like that. All right. Tips like this are in my new book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 Greatest Excel Tips of All Time. This is actually the book that we use in those live seminars. So if you can't make it to one of the seminars, next best thing, buy the book. You'll see all the tips that we talk about. Unfortunately, without the jokes and interaction with the audience, like this conversation with Lindsey in Nashville. All right, so you have a pivot table data source with daily dates. You'd like to filter by quarter. Follow these steps. Build a new pivot table, put dates in the row area. If it automatically groups, press control+Z to undo. Group those daily dates to quarters. Move the date to the report filter. Build the rest of your pivot table, and then optionally add a slicer by quarter. Down in the YouTube description is a link to today's article where you can download the workbook from today if you'd like to try along. Also, a list of our upcoming seminars down in that area. Well, hey, I want to thank Lindsey for showing up at my seminar in Nashville, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.